from my so I want to give some sort of the introduction about the Dr. Acharya, Acharya and his work experience and other kinds of research know-how. So this is Dr. Amulya sir. He is an associate professor in the departments of the Fakir Mohan University, Balasore, Odisha. He has the experience about the about 18 years and an associate professor in the Mahavidyalaya Sodhpur, Kolkata for 10 years. And he has been as assistant professor in the Ishad Institute of Management, Noida, and principal B.Ed. College, Burdwan. And he has a good number of the publication, near about 25 in number, in mostly in international as well as in national journals. So including he has two number of books that he has published and a good number of the chapters he has been published in different kinds of different books of international standard. So including he is the chief patron, as we can say, members of and chief editor of Sikhist journals and member of the AIERTA and AITA. Once again, I want to say good evening, Dr. Acharya sir. Please, I'm going to hand over this lecture to you for your worthy presentation and give us some insights about the research tools in the present period of time. How we can say utilize all these techniques? What are the different implications of these research techniques from your point of view? Please, sir.
At first, it's my thanks and gratitude to the organizer, Government Degree College, Tangmarg, Jammu and Kashmir, in collaboration to the Co-op and Co-Brain Trust India, for this international virtual FTP on tools and techniques in research. So my topic assigned to me is report writing. So far as research report writing is concerned, you know, this is an integral part and considered the major component of any research study, as the research remains incomplete till the report has been presented or written. In the entire research process, whatever we do, that one has to write it meticulously. A good research study is we have to conduct the research study, and what we have conducted, the findings of the research are of a little value unless they are effectively documented and communicated to others. But we have often seen, for a beginners, or it may be the experienced one, or you can say a potential researcher, sometimes they make mistakes while they are writing reports. And writing report is the, as you know, it is the last step of our entire research study. And it requires a set of skills, somewhat which is different from those called for in actually conducting a research. In research reports, entire research report vary greatly in length and type depending on the subject. And writing the research report, that there must be certain precautions while we are writing research report. That must have a logical, clear structure. It must be to the point, simple language we must use, and must have a pleasant layout. And the research report broadly have three parts. We can divide in broadly three parts. That is the preliminary pages, the main text of the research report, and the end matters. In the preliminary pages, that what we have to do, that we have to mention title and cover page, that is very important, a foreword, preface, acknowledgements, table of contents, list of tables, list of figures, list of appendices, and list of abbreviations, and executive summary. So these are the basis of a preliminary pages of research reports that we must not ignore while we are writing a title and cover page. A foreword must be there. Preface we must mention. We must acknowledge the persons. Table of contents must be mentioned properly. And list of tables, list of figures, list of appendices, and list of abbreviations and executing summary. These are the main parameters of a research report. And while we are writing title and cover page, certain precautions we must follow and certain principles we must follow. And the basis of writing title and cover page, that cover page should contain the title, names of the authors with the designations, the institution's name or affiliations, you can say, and that is publishing the report with its logo, the month, the year of publication. The title could consist of a challenging statement or question followed by an informative subtitle covering the content of the study and indicating the area where the study was implemented. It would be appropriate if the cover page is designed by an expert in computer graphics who may be suggested to include some important photographs related to identity of organization or problem under study or from the field within the background. So these are the basis of title and cover pages we must include while we are writing or mentioning the title and cover pages. We must be careful not to ignore all these things. And next one is foreword. A foreword is usually a short piece of writing found at the beginning of the book or author or a piece of literature before the introduction. And this may or may not be written by the primary author of the work. Often a foreword will tell of some interaction between the writer of the foreword and the story or the writer of the story. And a foreword to later editions of a work often explains how the new edition differs from previous ones. Unlike a preface, a foreword is always signed. And what is preface? A preface, by contrast, is written by the author of the book. That you must mention there. A preface generally covers the story of the book, came into being, or how the idea for the book was developed. This is often followed by thanks and acknowledgement to the people who were helpful to the author during the time of writing or the research work. A preface is an introduction to the book or other literary work written by the works by the author. Then acknowledgement. This is very important. We must acknowledge the persons, those who are in the entire research process. It is good practice to thank those who supported you technically or financially in the design and implementation of your study. You should not forget to thank your research guide and your employer too, who has allowed you to invest time in the study, and the respondents may be acknowledged. You should not forget to acknowledge the contribution of computer professional, library staffs, local officials, community where you have got information, or those who have provided information. And acknowledgements are usually placed right after the title page or at the end of the report before the references. Then we must mention the table of contents. It's very essential and vital that one can be clear what are the tables you have mentioned in your entire research work, how you have limited it. It provides the reader a quick overview of the chapters with major sections and subsections of your report and page references, so that the reader can go through the report in a different order or skip certain sections. The sections and subsections within each chapter may be given numbers that are specific to the chapter. Then we have to come to the summary, that research summary or executive summary, which is quite vital. The summary should be written only after the first or even the second draft of the report has been completed. What we have to mention in the summary? A very brief description of the problem, that we must mention about the problem, that in the summary we must define the problem, and we must explain about the problem. And in there, we have to mention the objectives, why has been studied, what was the purpose and objective of the study, and the place of the study, that we must mention, what are the sample and where we have done the work, and the population that we have selected, that we must mention the place of the study, the type of study and methods used, that is very important, that what are the methods we have used, and the major findings and conclusion, that what entire research work, what we found. Then we have to mention the major findings and conclusion, then the major recommendations for further research, or all recommendations. So in a research report, the chaptering of the research report, though it varies, there is no watertight compartment if you see, particularly in social science research or education research or in humanities, that we follow a particular standard. But in other, in science subjects, in pure science or in mathematics or any other research, that they follow a different pattern. But there are certain variations, but in spite of those variations, certain standards we maintain, that we must have a chapter that is introduction chapter, that is quite important, that the theoretical background, the components of your research work, that the historical background, that you have to mention in the introduction chapter, and review of literature, that which was a basis of your research work, that review of literature. Then methodology, what are the methodology you followed, that tools you have used, that questionnaire you have followed, or interview schedules or rating scales, whatever you followed, that you have to mention, and the statistical techniques you have used, that whether you have taken the your self-made questionnaire or standardized, that description about the tools, everything you have to mention here. Then research findings, after methodology, then here you have to mention that what are the findings you have got, that after analysis and interpretation, that findings you have to do. Then discussion of the results, conclusion and recommendations, and summary. In the introduction chapter, that introduction is just like the footprint of your entire research work, which will give you a direction to reach in the research work. The introduction is relatively easy part of the report, but you must write it very well. That can be best written after a first draft of the findings has been made. And it should certainly contain some relevant background data, information about the topic on which you are carrying out research. You may make addition to the corresponding section in your research proposal, including additional literature, and use it for your report. Then the statement of the problem should follow, again revised from your report writing, research proposal with additional comments, and relevant literature collected during the implementation of the study. In the review of related literature, that a literature review is the body of the text that aims to review the critical points of current knowledge or methodology approaches on a particular topic. That reviews are the secondary sources, as such do not report any new or original experimental work. Its ultimate goal is to bring the reader up to date with current literature on a topic, and forms the basis for another goal, such as future research that may be needed in the area. A well-structured literature review is characterized by a logical flow of ideas, current and relevant references with consistent, appropriate referencing style, proper use of terminology, and an unbiased and comprehensive view of previous research on the topic. Our one research study should be presented in one paragraph, and it should mention the name of the researcher, year of study, topic and area of study, sample size, main objective, and findings of the study. And that is very important while we are writing review of related literature. And the methodology, in the methodology section, the methodology section should include a description of the study type, major study themes or variables, the study targets, that is population, sampling methods, and the size of the samples, data collection techniques we followed, used for the different study populations, duration of data collection, that how much time you took, how the data was collected, the procedure of data, and to whom you applied, procedure used for data analysis, including statistical techniques you applied or employed, any constraints and its management, and limitation of the study. And next part is research findings. The research findings, after collection of the data, interpretation and analysis of the data, and that findings, what you got from the previous studies, what you have collected or what you got from the previous studies or reviews, the discussion of the result, that is very important. After that, research findings, you will do a detailed presentation of the findings of the study with supporting data in the form of tables and charts together with a validation of the results in the next step in the writing of the text of the report. The result section of the study should contain the statistical summaries, that is a reduction of data rather than raw data. All the results should be presented in a logical sequence and split into readily identifiable sections. The systematic presentation of your findings in relation to the research objective is the crucial part of your report. Include only those tables and figures that present main findings and need more elaborate discussion in the text. It is advisable to involve statistician or data analyst from the very beginning and in each process of the research so that you may provide meaningful tables and himself judge the irrelevant findings. And if you are expertise, you can do of your own without taking help of any technical experts, those or statistician, and discussion. The findings can now be discussed by objective or by cluster of related variables or the themes as you have mentioned in the objective part or in the hypothesis part. Basing on that, you have to discuss the result, which should lead to the conclusion and possible recommendation. The discussion may also include findings from other related studies that support or contradict your own. In the discussion of the result is very vital, as you know, that what you have got from the previous researcher and what you have got from your present study, that you have to relate, and whether your information or your research studies or your results that supports or contradicts, basing on your objectives and hypothesis. And the next part is conclusion and recommendations. The conclusion and recommendations should follow logically from the discussion of the findings, as the discussion will follow the sequence in which the findings have been presented, which in turn depend on your objectives. The conclusion should logically follow the same order. The conclusion should be given in bullets so that it can easily catch the attention of the reader. The conclusion should be followed by suggestions or recommendations. While making recommendations, use not only the findings of your study, but also supportive information from other sources. The recommendation should be generated from the findings and conclusion. It should not be generalized. Rather, it should be specific to a particular stakeholders in pure, actionable terms, which is feasible in relation to social context, policy, constitution of country, political acceptability, budget and time, etc. And the references, that is quite important. You must mention the work, what you have followed, or the research studies or reviews you have done, or any ideas you have taken, or you have mentioned in your research study. For the references, you have to mention the references should be given in the following order: that name of the author, last name first, title, underline to indicate italics, place, publisher and date of publication, and number of volumes. And references, you know, there are different referencing style. As you know, in particularly in education and social science, we follow APA style, and for literature some follows MLA. Like this, there are different referencing styles, so we have to follow according to our research area. The annexes should contain, that is annexure, the annexes should contain any additional information needed to enable professional to follow your research procedure and data analysis. Information that would be useful to special categories of readers but is not of interest to all average reader can be included in annexes as well. Example of information that can be presented in annexes are tables, figures, graphs and pictures referred to in the text but not included in order to keep the report short. List of hospitals, district, villages, etc. that participated in the study, the questionnaire which you have followed, or interview schedule, or checklist, or any data for collection that you must enclose in the annex. A list of research team members, those who have been involved in the research process, you must mention in the annexes. And style and layout of the report. Remember that your reader is a short of time, that you are not going to write many things or a vast report. You must not do. The report must be very precise and has many other urgent matters demanding his or her interest and attention. Is probably not knowledgeable concerning research jargon. Therefore, the rules are simplify, keep to the essentials. Don't mention anything else, whatever coming to your mind. You write it in a simplified manner. Give the point, essential points which are required, the major findings that you must mention and justify. Make no statement that is not based on the facts and data. Don't give any irrelevant data or information which are not required, and that is very important. And certain rules we must follow, that keep to the essentials, make no statement that is not based on the facts and data. Do not quote the name of anyone who has provided the information for writing report. Be precise and specific in your phrasing of findings. Inform, not impress. Avoid exaggeration. Use short sentences. Use adverbs and adjectives infrequently. Be consistent in the use of past and present tenses. Aim to be logical and systematic in your presentation. And layout of the report, that is very important. The way you are layout, that will impress to the readers, to the persons, those who will go through your research report. A good physical layout is important, as it will help your report. Make a good initial impression, encourage the readers, give them an idea of how the material has been organized. And particular attention should be paid to make sure there is an attractive layout for the title page and a clear table of contents, consistency in margin and spacing, consistency in heading and subheadings, that is font size, maybe 16 or 18 bold for heading of chapter, size 14 bold for headings of major sections, and size 12 bold for heading of subsections, etc. And sometimes you might have seen and might have observed that a particular journals or particular granting authority, they mention what should be the research report. Basing on that, their recommendations and their guidelines, we have to write the reports. But this is the ideal, as I have mentioned. Good quality printing and photocopying. So while we are submitting any report, that must be a very good quality printing, or if you are doing photocopying, and that must be clear and visible, and correct drafts carefully with spell check as well as critical reading for clarity by other team members, your facilitator, and if possible outsiders, you must take help. Numbering of figures and tables, that must be very, you must be very careful. Provision of clear titles for tables, every tables, there must be a clear titles. Then the reader can understand what is that title, a table, why for you have mentioned that table, and what is the importance of that table. One can see and get clear idea about the table you have mentioned. And clear headings for columns and rows, that you must not forget to mention. While you are mentioning any headings for columns, you must mention clear headings for column and rows for your research report. Accuracy and consistency in quotation and references, where you are giving, you give accurate and consistent quotation and references while you are writing report or giving any quotation or references. And common weakness in the report writing and finalizing the text, we see sometimes we commit and we observe some common weakness in report writing. The people they commit, that is endless description. That I have seen also some of my students, they prepare a thesis report, they write report of 200-300 pages and simply they have repeated the matters, and that endless description you should avoid. Without interpretation is a pitfall. Tables need conclusion. Every tables you must give certain conclusion. Not detailed presentation of all numbers or percentage in the cells which readers can see for themselves. So endless description, that you must avoid. Neglect of a qualitative data is also quite common. So quotes of informants as illustration of your findings and conclusion make your report lively. Presentation of important photographs also make report attractive and explains facts better. So while you are doing qualitative research, so you should not neglect any qualitative data what you have collected. That will, if you put those things, that your presentation, that will, your report will be lively like, and it will explain itself. It will be clear to the readers. Sometimes qualitative data like open opinion questions are just coded and counted like quantitative data without interpretation, whereas they may be provide interesting illustration of reasons for behavior of informants or their attitudes. That you must mention. This is serious maltreatment of data that needs correction. This is, you have to be very careful. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr.
So, thank you, participants and organizers. Now, it's a time for...
Thanks, Dr. Amulya Kumar Ajaya, for sharing with us quite precious information about how the report can be arrived out, and what are the different steps that we must have, that we must keep the attention towards upon while you are preparing or while you are going to draft some sort of the report. And you discussed about the different kinds of the contents, about the preface, about the, what is the role of the acknowledgement, or how the table of the contents will be prepared, and then after the executive summary and presentation of the research report accordingly, what are the common errors that we must that we are need to put the mind upon while we are drafting some sort of the report. So I'm going to now give the chance to all of the participants who are listening their experience about the tools and techniques of research. Is there any kind of the participants who have any sort of the question about this today's experience that has been given by Dr. Ajaya? Is any participant, have you any kind of the question? Please raise your hand. Yes. Is there any question from the participant side? Please ask the Dr. Amulya Kumar, sir.
Yes, sir.
Do you have any, hello participants, do you have any sort of question about the today's topic? Now, I think there's nobody who has any sort of the we can say doubt about the tools and techniques of research that has been imposed by Dr. Ajaya.